अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, डॉक्टर मारिया हेयर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द शोल्डर प्रेजेंटेशन विच इज अ मेल प्रेजेंटेशन। सो वी आर डूइंग द पार्ट 3 ऑफ मेल प्रेजेंटेशन। इन आवर प्रीवियस टू लेक्चर्स वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द लाई, वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द नॉर्मल प्रेजेंटेशन, वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द फेस प्रेजेंटेशन एंड ब्रो प्रेजेंटेशन। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट द शोल्डर प्रेजेंटेशन। Before starting the shoulder presentation, just have a quick recap of the normal fetal terminologies. Normally what happens that the long axis of the fetus lies parallel to the long axis of the uterus. It means that the normal fetal lies longitudinal lie because the long axis of the fetus is parallel to the long axis of the uterus. Now what about the normal fetal presentation? What is fetal presentation? The part of the fetus that directly overlies the maternal pelvis inlet. Normally, the vertex first goes into the pelvis. Now, what is the vertex? Vertex is the part of the fetal skull. It is the distance between the anterior fontanel till the posterior fontanel. So, this part is the vertex. So when we say that the fetal head first goes into the maternal pelvis, normally we are talking about the vertex, right? Mean vertex goes first into the maternal pelvis. So what is the normal presentation of the fetus? It is the vertex presentation. Fetus presents its vertex first to the maternal pelvis. So normal presentation is the vertex presentation. Now, what is the normal fetal position? What is meant by a normal fetal position? Mean when we first decide that what is the presenting part, for example, normally the presenting part is the vertex. Then we have to choose one bony part in that presenting part which will tell us the position of the baby or the position of the presenting part. For example, as head is going first into the maternal pelvis, mean the vertex is going first into the maternal pelvis and we have to do the vaginal examination, we will feel occiput and we will describe the position of this presenting part relative to the maternal pelvis. Either it is towards the anterior side of the pelvis or towards the posterior side of the pelvis. For example, in this case, the occiput is towards the anterior side of the pelvis or is towards the pelvis or is towards the pubis. So here we say that occiput anterior. So here the fetal position is occiput anterior. When I say that the position is occiput anterior, it means that the presentation is vertex, because according to the presentation we have to choose a bony part, that is the denominator by which we tells the position, and that position is the fetal position. Now in this picture, the lie is longitudinal. The presenting part is vertex. Mean head is going first. It is a cephalic presentation. And more correctly, we should say that vertex presentation. Now what is the position of this fetus? What is the fetal position? First of all, you have said that it is a vertex presentation. When there is a vertex presentation, the bony part which we select to describe the position of the presenting part is called denominator. What will be the denominator or which bony part we will choose in case of vertex? That will be occiput. Right? Now tell me, what is the position of occiput here? This is the frontal bone. Occiput is on the back. Occiput is towards the sacrum. So occiput is posterior. So fetal position is occiput posterior. So normal lie is longitudinal. Normal presentation is vertex. Normal position is occiput anterior. As normal presentation is a vertex presentation because fetus has to present its vertex first. But if the fetus presents any other part than the vertex, that will be not a normal presentation. That will be abnormal presentation. So what is shoulder presentation? Shoulder presentation is a type of malpresentation or abnormal presentation in which fetal shoulder first goes into the maternal pelvis or is the presenting part. Now these are important OSCE, VIVA and MCQ points, that what is the incidence of shoulder presentation? The incidence is 1 in 200 labors or deliveries according to Dewhurst. In which lie there is shoulder presentation? Always remember, in oblique lie and in transverse lie, there can be the shoulder presentation. In this picture, we can see that the long axis of the fetus is making an angle of 45 with the long axis of the uterus, or the baby is present obliquely. So this is a oblique lie in which the shoulder is in contact with maternal pelvis first, or the fetal shoulder is the presenting part. So there is a shoulder presentation. Now, what is the denominator of shoulder presentation? Whenever there is a shoulder presentation on PV or the pervaginal examination, we have to choose a bony part according to which we can tell the position of shoulder. So acromion, which is a bony process of scapula, is the denominator. Mean in shoulder presentation, we choose acromion as a denominator. We have to feel on pervaginal examination, this bony part is either towards the anterior side of pelvis or is towards the posterior side of the pelvis. Either it is acromio-anterior or acromio-posterior. To tell the position of the presenting part, although it is difficult to tell the fetal position in shoulder presentation, but an expert can tell. Now we should know what are the causes of shoulder presentation. The general causes of malpresentation applies for the shoulder presentation, but especially the multiple gestation, prematurity and placenta previa are the more common causes associated with the shoulder presentation, right? And to memorize the causes of malpresentation, I have told you a mnemonic in lecture 1. So you can use this mnemonic to memorize all these causes. So kindly watch lecture number 1 of malpresentation. Now you should know the complications of shoulder presentation. The specific complications that are associated with shoulder presentation is cord prolapse and is hand or arm prolapse. So if this question comes during VIVA or OSCE, first of all write these two complications. As in this presentation, head is not the presenting part. So when membranes will rupture, the cord will prolapse easily and there will be hand or arm prolapse. Whenever examiner asks you the complication of any malpresentation, write down these four complications in any malpresentation. So you have to write the cord prolapse, uterine rupture, obstructed labor, fetal hypoxia and death. And in shoulder presentation, cord prolapse and hand or arm prolapse are more commonly associated. So you should know the most commonly associated complication. Now how you will diagnose the shoulder presentation? First of all, you have to take the history from the patient, because most of the patient will tell you that their doctor last time told them they don't have a normal fetal lie. Sometimes even they will point that in this part of the abdomen there is a fetal head. So most of the patients are aware about the lie of the baby. So always ask the patient. So history is important. Sometimes patients have unstable lie. Number second, ultrasound is very important. It will clearly tell you about the lie, about the fetal presentation. It is important to rule out the placenta previa, because whenever there is a shoulder presentation, always rule out placenta previa. Number third, examination is very important. So what is the first step of abdominal examination? The first step of abdominal examination is inspection. You will do inspection. And what you will note on inspection, you will note that the fundal height is less and the abdomen is broader. Normally, the fundal height is more as compared to the width of the abdomen. But in this case, they will be nearly equal. So, inspection is very important. Number two, you will do abdominal palpation. And how you will palpate the abdomen? You will use the Leupold's maneuvers. In Leupold's maneuver, first of all, you will do the fundal grip that permits the determination of uterine fundus level as well as the fetal presentation. In shoulder presentation, the fundus level will be less as compared to normal fetal lie. Then you will do the umbilical grip. Normally in umbilical grip, what you feel the fetal spine on one side, either on the right side or on the left side. But during the shoulder presentation, either the fetus has oblique lie or the transverse lie. In transverse lie, the head and the breech will be felt at the same level. While in oblique lie, one pole, usually the head because it is heavier, is felt in lower level, mean in the iliac fossa. And the buttocks and the legs will be felt in the higher level. Then you will do the third maneuver, that is the pauric grip. In pauric grip, normally what happens, you feel the fetal head. But in shoulder presentation, you will not able to feel the fetal head. So in pauric grips, you will say that you are not able to feel the fetal head. Now on perivaginal examination, what you will feel that the presenting part is high or there is a shoulder. And if there is a transverse lie, you may feel ribs, but you will not feel the head, right? You may feel the bulging membranes, you may feel the cord, but you will not able to feel the head of the fetus. Okay, now what is the management of shoulder presentation? Always remember, whenever any examiner asks you about the management of shoulder presentation, always go for cesarean section. Always go for operation, right? Always remember, whenever there is a shoulder presentation, it is not possible to deliver such fetus vaginally. So you have to go for cesarean section, right? First, make this concept. Now, you should know some extra points which are very important. If a pregnant lady comes to an OPD at 38 weeks with a persistent oblique or a transverse lie, admit the patient. Because anytime the membranes can rupture, there can be cord prolapse, there can be arm prolapse. Number second thing, shoulder presentation can occur in transverse lie and in oblique lie. Whenever there is an oblique lie, go for C-section. When there is a transverse lie, in very early labor, external spheric version can be offered, but mostly it is not in practice. By this maneuver, the transverse lie can be converted into the normal lie, that is the vortex lie, and then we will assist the vaginal delivery. But remember, if in any scenario it is mentioned that the membranes are ruptured and they are uterine contractions, never ever do this procedure, that is the external cephalic version, and immediately go for cesarean section. Mean you have to do emergency lower segment C-section. Why? Because to avoid the impacted transverse lie, because then it will be very difficult to deliver such baby even with cesarean, and there will be trauma to baby as well as to the mother. So this point is very important. And as the membranes are ruptured, there can be the cord prolapse, and the cord prolapse can cause the fetal hypoxia and fetal death. So whenever the membranes are ruptured or there are uterine contractions, do not wait. Immediately go for emergency cesarean section, right? But if on perivaginal examination you feel that there is molding around the uterus, go for classical C-section. So if someone asks you in which case you will do the classical C-section, you will do classical C-section in shoulder presentation or in an abnormal lie when there is a molding around the uterus. And why you want to do this? Because to prevent maternal and fetal trauma. So in a nutshell, when there is a shoulder presentation, go for C-section. When there is an oblique lie, go for C-section. When there is a transverse lie, only in early labor, you can do external cephalic version. Otherwise, best management is caesarean. When the membranes are ruptured, when there are uterine contractions, you will not do external cephalic version. In case of shoulder presentation, oblique lie or transverse lie, if there's a molding around the uterus, best procedure is classical C-section. Now we will do the mnemonics of shoulder presentation. To memorize this whole topic, you just have to remember this line. Your presentation should be outclass. Don't relax and please prepare. So it is just the order to a girl to prepare presentation. Now how we will decode this? As the name of the topic is shoulder presentation, so from here you should know that it is about the presentation. So your presentation should. Here's the word presentation and here I have written the presentation. Here's the word the shoulder. And here it is the should. From this word shoulder, we can write it as should. Next word is outclass. What it's mean? O for oblique lie and T for transverse lie. And the class mean C for C. S mean section. L here mean lower and this S means segment. So what is the meaning of outclass here? It means that whenever there is an oblique lie, when there is a transverse lie, we will go for C-section. And generally, the lower segment C-section, right? So what it means as a whole? Whenever there is a shoulder presentation, the lie will be either oblique or transverse. And whenever there is a shoulder presentation or oblique or transverse lie, go for C-section and generally the lower segment C-section, right? Now here the word relax mean, here is the word lex. You will write as lex, uterine and abdominal muscles. And now how you will decode this word, please prepare. Here the PL mean placenta and this and here PRE pre mean previa. So you will write as placenta previa. And this pre also mean prematurity. Here please prepare has two meaning. Number one is the placenta previa and number two is the prematurity. What it's mean? Don't relax and please prepare mean that these are the most important causes of shoulder presentation. What are the most important causes of shoulder presentation? These are the lex, uterine and abdominal muscles. It is the placenta previa and prematurity. Right? So if you memorize these two lines, you will be able to remember your whole topic. So in a nutshell, your presentation should be outclass. Don't relax and please prepare. Close your eyes. Revise it 2 to 3 times and you are done with it. So your presentation should be mean in a shoulder presentation. Outclass mean there is a oblique or transverse lie. And in shoulder presentation, you will do C-section and generally the lower segment C-section, right? If there is a molding around the uterus, then you can go for classical C-section. Otherwise, you will do lower segment C-section. Don't relax and please prepare tells about the causes of shoulder presentation that are the lex abdominal and uterine muscles and placenta previa and prematurity. Now we will do some MCQs and always remember the repetition of MCQs doesn't mean the same lines will come in exams. You should know the concept. If you are going to crack any exam, you should know how to study. And how to prepare a topic, right? For example, here is a scenario. A Gravida 3-para 2 presented at 38 weeks of gestation with labor pains for last 6 hours. On examination, the lie of fetus was oblique, right? First, we will highlight this point. Cervical os was 5 cm, dilated with bulging membranes and presenting part was shoulder. CTG was reactive. What would be the most appropriate management for her? Remember, first thing, it does not matter that how long the scenario is, so never ever confuse. Number second thing, always find the clues. As I have told you that whenever there is an oblique lie, always go for C-section. Whenever there is a shoulder lie, always go for C-section. If she is not in labor and she is at term, we have to go for cesarean, right? But in such case, we can give her date or we can delay 1 or 2 days. So we can do elective C-section, right? But if a patient is in labor, we are worried about the ruptured membranes and the cord prolapse because that will cause the fetal hypoxia and fetal death. So we will do cesarean section, but immediately. Right? As in this case, she is in labor and there is a shoulder presentation and there is an oblique lie. The both words are saying that you should go for cesarean section immediately. So you will go for emergency cesarean C-section, okay, immediately. So you will choose this. Now, if the same scenario again comes in your exam, right? But in that scenario here, the CTG was non-reactive is written, then what you will do? Non-reactive means there is IUD or there is a fetal demise. Whenever there is a fetal demise and there is an oblique lie or a shoulder presentation, you cannot go for vaginal delivery. As the patient is in labor and although the baby is dead, again you will go immediately for C-section to avoid the maternal trauma, right? So in case of fetal demise, if a patient is at term and she is in labor, immediately go for cesarean section. Now, the next scenario. A Gravida 3 para 2 presented at 38 weeks of gestation with labor pains for last 4 hours. On examination, the lie of fetus was transverse. So, first highlight this. Cervical os was 5 cm dilated with bulging membranes and presenting part was not reachable. CTG was reactive. What would be the most appropriate management for her? Now, she is in labor for last 4 hours, mean it is not very early labor. And the lie of fetus is transverse. As it is not very early labor and she is in labor for last 4 hours, right? So you cannot do external cephalic version because for external cephalic version, you can do it in very early labor. And here the cervical os was 5 cm dilated and the membranes are bulging. I mean any time they can rupture and there can be cord prolapse, right? So what you will do? You will do cesarean section immediately because whenever there is a transverse lie, we do emergency cesarean section immediately to avoid impacted transverse lie, right? Otherwise, it would be very difficult to deliver such baby and there will be trauma to mother as well as fetus. Now, if the same scenario again comes in exam and here it is written that the presenting part was shoulder, then if the presenting part is shoulder, then what you will do? Again, you will go for emergency cesarean section immediately. Right? Now the last scenario, which is very important, a Gravida 2 pair 1 presented at 39 weeks of gestation with labor pains for last 4 hours. On examination, the lie of fetus was transverse. Cervical os was 5 cm. Dilated and presenting part was shoulder. CTG was reactive. Uterus is founded to be molded around the fetus. Right? This is a very important line because there is a molding. What would be the most appropriate management for her? Now, there is a transverse lie and The presenting part is shoulder. Whenever there's a transverse lie, as we know that in transverse lie, the presenting part can be shoulder, it can be back, right? Now, in this scenario, the presenting part is shoulder. And whenever the presenting part is shoulder, we cannot do external cephalic version, number one. And number second thing is that, as she is in labor, right? Then any time membranes can be ruptured and there can be cord prolapse causing the fetal hypoxia and death. And an additional thing is that there is a molding around the fetus. The above lines are indicating that you should go for emergency C-section, right? And this key word, molded around fetus, this word is telling you that you have to use such approach that is recommended to avoid both fetal and maternal trauma. So what you will do? So you will do classical C-section. So this is very important.